Wait. Wait.
It is graffiti.
Graffiti, yeah.
Wait, graffiti. Graffiti is connected with hip hop.
It's the better type of graffiti.
I like the graffiti.
Straight graffiti is writing on walls.
Combat graffiti. Combat graffiti. Combat. Combat. Combat graffiti. And since this building was quite badly graffiti, it was decided that we ought to try a community arts project and to produce some murals.
Graffiti. What is it? Is it a scourge of modern day society created by young teenagers wearing baggy jeans and trainers, scribbling obscene messages on walls and saying like things like "Cowabunga, I'm wicked"? Or is it a progressive art form in the 90s, ever aspiring to its greatest potential? In this video, we're going to find out who does it, where they do it, why they do it, when they do it, and do people like it? Do people dislike it? Where do you want to put it? Where do you want... You find out for yourself.
What do you define as graffiti? How would you see graffiti?
Well, I think straight graffiti is writing on the walls and is seen as a sort of very unpositive way of communicating throughout the community. Personally, I think there's a pro and a con to graffiti. There's also the whole question of graffiti art. I think the problem with graffiti, as I've already said, is that it's a lack of understanding of why people do it, why people need to do it, and also a lack of understanding of where people don't want it.
On this particular site, we've had a lot of graffiti, a lot of which has been very obscene, and because this makes it very difficult for young children to come to the site and play in the sort of environment that they should be offered. Vandalism that goes along with that is also a great problem to us, and this particular site has cost us over £2,000 in the last month to carry out repairs to.
So what sort of like offence would they, what would they be up for, as it were?
Well, the offence, as I mentioned, would be criminal damage, causing criminal damage to something which doesn't belong to them. In this case, the wall here obviously belongs to the church as opposed to them, and
is there a fine that. Or?
Well, with criminal damage, you could be looking at a long prison sentence if it was persistent. But in this sort of thing, yes, I mean, depending on the age group, you could be looking at a fine or some form of community service order or something like that.
What is the extent of the problem that you face of graffiti in Colchester Borough Council?
Well, it's difficult to say because no one's done a study to look at the extent to which the council area is covered with graffiti. But we know that there are certain places within the borough which are quite badly affected. Yeah. There are buildings where there are lots of tags, and there are a few places who are affected by rather obscene graffiti.
Complaints? Do you have a lot of complaints about it?
The number of complaints tends to fluctuate over time. And at the moment, I think there's a general impression that the level of graffiti has got worse in Colchester, and I think we'll anticipate that in the near future we'll start getting an increasing number of complaints. Yeah. It'll reach a peak, and action will be taken somehow, I suppose, and then the complaints will die off.
How much action is taken now against graffiti?
Well, the council takes quite a lot of action. It tends to act, providing it knows that the graffiti is there, within 21 days of it appearing. So that's quite prompt action to remove the graffiti from its buildings and premises. The problem is buildings which aren't in the council's control, and where private individuals are responsible. There it's a very different matter. Sometimes it can be left for years.
And since this building was quite badly graffitied, it was decided that we ought to try a community arts project and to produce some murals.
Would you class this as graffiti, what we're doing writing on walls in a certain way?
Some people might, and some parts of the mural are very definitely graffiti art, but there's something quite good about it.
What's the definition between graffiti and art? Have you got your own definition?
Yeah, I'd probably have my definition. I think graffiti is something that defaces a public building, either with offensive words or offensive signs. Whereas graffiti art is perhaps a creative art form.
And you encourage this?
I would certainly encourage it in certain places, this being one of them.
So you're pleased with what happened? You had a group of children and some older ages?
Yes, right across the age range. When this was done, we had in fact a workshop operating
over a weekend and then on 4 days into the next week. And children and community groups and organisations all took part with two community artists, with Lisa and Chris, who actually organised the work and produced some drawings and some paintings with a lot of the children. And a lot of young people took part in it as well.
Yeah, there was a lot of young people. Yeah. I was here when it was happening. Some good responses.
I think it's nice when it's done like this, but I, you know, when you've got permission to do it, you've got the pictures done. But I don't like graffiti when it's just splattered everywhere, you know?
Just
like kids messing about.
Oh yes, brightens things up.
It does, brightens a lot of things up.
Yes, yeah. Not half. Yeah, especially the cat.
The cat, you like the cat.
As working in a shop in the nearby area, sort of like just opposite, how do you react to the actual mural? Does it lighten up?
Yeah, it's definitely a big improvement. It's a lot better than the graffiti that was there before, and it definitely brightens up the environment. Yeah.
Is there a difference between like that one and some like stylized?
Can't read that one.
You can't actually read it, but that does look more sort of picturesque than that.
Oh, you prefer actually that one?
That little place there.
That piece to the actual mural.
But the place around the back there is
much better than what the kids have done.
It's much better, yeah.
What happened now? What was all this about? What was the main aims of the project?
Well, basically, the idea was, because these walls being so large and blank, they're a perfect target for, like, obviously, the local dissatisfied graffiti youth. Yes. And the council thought that if they were actually involved in painting a mural on it, they'd be less likely to deface it.
Yes.
And
has it worked? Have you had the community all joining in?
We've had quite a few of the younger members of the community joining in.
But
and they've enjoyed it tremendously.
Yeah, but it's not been
there hasn't been that much support from, the secondary schools, really. We've had a few older people.
And we've seen an old gentleman.
He was great.
Painting,
he was really marvellous. And he was helpful with the kids as well.
That's good. So has it been a success in your eyes, you think?
I think it has. And, you know, it looks nice. We've had a lot of people commenting on how nice it does look.
Yeah.
And I think it is much less likely to be graffitied on.
Do you reckon now? Is that a definite?
Apparently there's a wall that was painted in Harwich in the similar problem area, and it hasn't had any graffiti on it for 5 years.
So it does work.
I think it will.
You just got to wait and see.
And also, someone pointed out, if they do graffiti on it, it doesn't look as bad as it would do on just a plain white wall.
Just a plain white wall, yeah.
Basically, it's just your tag done in three-dimensional letters.
So there's a difference between a piece and a tag.
Yeah,
what is that?
Very much so. A tag is just like with a spray can or a marker pen, and you write your name. It's usually a name, not usually your own. You make up a name. And you just write it everywhere. It's called getting up. Tagging is...
Getting up?
Getting up.
That's tagging.
Yeah.
A piece is...
The pieces. Well, what I'm in the middle of doing.
That's the right thing. What's this actually going to say?
This is my tag, which is demo.
Yeah.
And it's got a character on the end, and it's got a radio at the top.
What does it mean? Have you got any sort of like, is there an actual meaning to it?
No, it's just art.
Just art. It's just what you want to do. How long have you been doing this then?
For about 2.5 years now.
Where have you been doing it? Sort of like where you can get space or where?
Yeah, wherever I can do it.
Yeah.
Youth club. Especially because we can do it legally there.
Yeah.
A lot of the stuff is done illegally that I do, like backs of garages, train stations, on trains. We're really spread out far and wide, and it's really hard to actually meet other people who do graffiti. It's mostly by chance that you actually meet other people.
Yeah. Do you ever, what about the space on wall? Do you ever really trouble with trying to get space?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah,
a real problem,
yeah, especially with legal pieces, because people don't still class it as vandalism. They don't realise that it's real art.
What about different styles of graffiti? What styles are there?
Well, this particular piece is going to be a flat 3D, which means it's very three-dimensional. You can get other sort of like shadow 3D,
yeah,
which is sort of like, it looks like it's, I don't know, fractured. Sort of, yeah, 3D so is below it,
yeah, I didn't, yeah,
at an angle. The most complicated style of graffiti is called wild style. You've got your letters, and they've got all connections and arrows and stuff. And they're all the letters are connected together in really intricate ways. And it's very hard to read. Sometimes it's unreadable to the naked eye, so to speak.
Oh, right, so that gives it a bit more prestige, does it? Yeah. Do you get many people who do that sort of, like, the wild, what's it called?
Wild style.
Wild style.
Yeah, wild style is very prolific in London at the moment.
Oh,
people like Kane One and State of Art use a lot of wild style. In fact, I think Kane, that's all
State
Kane
of
One
Art,
does.
Rap groups, isn't it? Yeah, State of Art.
State of Art.
State of Art.
He's one of the most famous writers in London.
Interior decorator. Graffiti style. Members at Strait Road Community Youth Centre had a choice of decorating their room in the style of their wanting. They chose graffiti. As you see, even inside, the whole genre of the sort of like outside graffiti street life is still created here with the walls. All the walls around here just show the sort of like outside view. Also, look at this, a tag. Now what happens when you get a piece or a creation, people tag the piece to show their approval or their dislike. As you can see, all around here, there's tags everywhere, so who knows?
So there you have it, graffiti. What do you think? You've heard our opinions, our views, different sides of the fence, how people react, how people don't react. Now what do you think? Well, you know, some people find it a pain in the neck, some people it's a way of life, some people find it frightening, some people find it... Well, there you have it. I can only say so much. Now it's up to you. Think on it.